In the faraway mountains of Kushi, in the north, live holy men. Their skin is like ice and snow, and they are shy as virgins. They do not eat grains, but breathe wind and drink dew. They ride on clouds, which are drawn by flying dragons. Roaming freely in the realm beyond the four seas. Nothing can harm such persons. Even in a great flood, with the waters reaching the sky, they will not drown. Even when the heat is extreme, melting metals and stones, scorching the earth, they will not be burned. Such holy beings are like birds. They rest a moment and feed like little ones. They rest a moment and feed like little ones. Then they fly away without leaving any trace. They prosper along with other beings. And when after a thousand years they have enough of this world, they leave it to join the other immortals on high, flying away in a white cloud, the land of the ancestor. We are a combination of five viscera, six receptors. Seven governors, nine palaces, skin and arteries, its muscles and bones, its marrow and brain, nine openings to keep and to protect, 12 dwellings for the spirits. At the left of my body reside the three heavenly souls. At the right, the seven earthly souls. The body has three stories, and each story has eight luminaries. So altogether, these have 24 gods, 12,000 vibrations, 360 articulations, and 84,000 pores. In the beginning, was not the word, but the sign, the image. There was something chaotic, and yet achieved, which existed before there were heaven and earth. There was silence and vastness. Standing alone, uninfluenced, making cyclical movements which pervade everything so as to become the mother of the world. There was silence and vastness. Once upon a time, I dreamt I was a butterfly, fluttering about like a butterfly should, happy and free, and not knowing that it was I. Suddenly, I woke up and realized with a start that it was I. Who knows now if I was dreaming that I was a butterfly or a butterfly dreaming that it was I? However, between me and the butterfly, certainly there must be a difference. There was silence and vastness. There was silence.